nation and heaven and earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when men revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven, for so many persecuted the prophets who went before you.
In fact, I believe it is fair to say that our differences are merely linguistic, cultural, and geographical. There is much that we owe to our beloved common early Czech fathers who have helped to shape the whole Czech in general and our respective traditions in particular. Throughout the centuries and even to this day, the faithful of our sister Czechs have maintained the Orthodox faith and principle that they have inherited from their forefathers. We thank God for your holiness stands among them, firmly maintaining the Orthodox faith and hope in your efforts towards reconciliation and peace. As we trust God for the future and rest in the hope which is ours in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we look also to your holiness's wise counsel and holy guidance. As we consider our future and seek to be faithful to God's purpose and mission for the Orthodox Church in the world today. Your Holiness, in honor of those wise and holy patriarchs who have gone in faith before us, and with appreciation for those standing in our midst today, we present to Your Holiness the work of the Holy Church Fathers of the Forsaken, a book called Haimanota, or the Faith of Our Father, which has meant so much to those of us of the Ethiopian Orthodox theology, for it is orthodoxy and it is absolute harmony with the Holy Scripture.
Your Holiness, Pope Shenouda, Your Gracious Archbishop and Bishop, members of the distinguished entourage, Your Grace, Abuna Paulos, ladies and gentlemen and friends, on behalf of the congregation and members of St. Mary's Ethiopian Orthodox Church, in Los Angeles, I consider it a signal honor and privilege to extend a warm and hearty welcome to His Holiness Pope Shenouda III and his distinguished party on this momentous occasion of their visit to our church. In his very busy schedule, the fact that His Holiness found time to visit us and to visit with us shows how much importance he attaches to Ethiopia and his Ethiopian spiritual children, for whom he has always displayed boundless love and affection. Both as a faithful member and a humble servant of the church, and as a former ambassador to Egypt, I have been particularly privileged to witness very closely the career of His Holiness and to follow the many twists and turns of His spiritual journey through life. I can therefore confidently state from the outset that his was a life of true courage and true devotion. In fact, his whole life is an embodiment of those two words, courage and devotion. In turn, his courage and devotion have been pillars of strength for all his co-religionists, not only in Egypt, but throughout the world. When I was in Egypt in the mid-70s, His Holiness was incarcerated and imprisoned by the authorities, all because of his courage to speak out strongly against the forces of evil and fanaticism, and because of his single-minded devotion to the just cause of his beloved people, the Copts of Egypt. But no amount of suffering, be it incarceration, imprisonment, banishment, restriction in movement, or any, will in any way deflect him from the path of devotion to the service of both God and man. His attitude is perhaps best described by the works of St. Paul, as found in Romans chapter 8, verses 35 to 37, where it says, "Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword?" And it is written, "For thy sake we are being killed all the day long, we are regarded as sheep to the slaughter. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us." Thus, suffering without bitterness, the hallmark of all true Christians, which is to follow in the footsteps of our Lord and Savior himself, is typified by the life of His Holiness, who teaches and leads all of us, both by example and precept. Tribulation for the Ethiopian people. Civil war, drought, and famine have taken a heavy toll. Both man-made and natural disasters that engulfed our people have resulted in the general disruption of peaceful life. This disruption has affected every aspect of national life, and that includes the church. Your Holiness, this is somewhat a sensitive matter, but I cannot start it without mentioning it. Ever since the imprisonment and subsequent disappearance of the properly elected and legitimate patriarch of the Ethiopian Orthodox Church, your good friend and brother, His Holiness Maguna Diopros, to all intents and purposes, the Ethiopian Church has been without a leader. In this connection, we adore the courageous stand taken by Your Holiness and the leaders of the Sister Orthodox Churches not to recognize anyone chosen by the present godless communist regime to be the head of the Ethiopian Church. This means until the death of His Holiness Abuna Theophilus is independently confirmed and established as a fact, and until such time as a proper election is held to replace him under conditions of peace and tranquility, in accordance with church law and tradition, the Ethiopian shall remain without a legitimate vision. In other words, until peace and tranquility return to Ethiopia, and free elections are held without any coercion, things will not be normal for our church. And the leadership will remain forever controversial. Your Holiness, today, for the first time in the history of our country, such large numbers of Ethiopians have been forced to leave their homeland and be scattered all over the world. Most of the people you see around you here today are here in the United States because of the dislocation created by the prevailing situation in Ethiopia. An estimated 10 to 15,000 live in this area. Over 100,000 throughout the United States. These are all industrious, hard-working Ethiopians who are reconstructing their lives from scratch in America, who are way ahead of us in adopting to life in the United States. It's our great ambition to emulate them and to follow their good example in preserving the best in our culture and tradition. By building churches and schools for the service of our people, we seek your guidance and support, and above all, your prayers in all these matters. It is our fervent hope that this visit of your Holiness will open the way for even greater collaboration and cooperation than ever before between our two communities, which have so much in common in shared history, commonly shared culture, and commonly shared values. As it has always been in the past, the church's resilience and strength renews itself in times of difficulty and hardship. Remarkably, the church has thrived and is still thriving in Ethiopia. In fact, I'm glad to report to your Holiness that in spite of the awful things that are happening in Ethiopia today, and perhaps because of them, church attendance is higher than it has ever been before. More churches are being built by the sheer efforts of the people, often in defiance of official policy. More and more young people are drawn to the church today than ever before. The spiritual nurture and sustenance that they are continually seeking in greater and greater numbers has to be satisfied. And this is in turn places great responsibility on the shoulders of our church leaders, both at home and abroad. Your Holiness, the whole world is aware of the need to satisfy hunger in Ethiopia. That is physical hunger. That is, in fact, very important, and we are very grateful for it. But as our Lord himself has taught us, man does not live by bread alone. Our spiritual leader and your great friend, His Grace Abuna Paulus, needs a lot of help in this regard. He and a handful of his fellow clergy are doing their level best to reach out to all the Ethiopians here in the United States who are in great need of spiritual food and nourishment. The harvest is in our minds because we see your Holiness as the very embodiment of those strong ties that bind us together. You are our spiritual father, and we have come to you from far and near to receive your blessings as your children. May God grant your Holiness long life and continued good health to enable you to bring God's blessings to all of us and to all mankind through your prayers and supplications for world peace, justice, and human dignity. Ethiopia in particular needs your prayers, and please, your Holiness, always remember Ethiopia.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Krishna, Govil, Mohan, Pastorus, Ahadallat, Amin.
Dear Bishop Paulus and dear bishops, our sons and
daughters.
I am very glad to be among you.
Tilik this day Samania Zari Kabahana Kalasho Katarini.
We don't know how deep we love our brothers and daughters and their students.
Yeah, effective validation, Lelinjo Church in Ka Ethiopia, Tilik, and now Bakar Ain.
We are one church.
Election and with Christian.
In 1972.
bizim edareku ve sadan sos amedine.
I would give me welcome by the great emperor Isis.
Dilek markam tadakwa lini visit za usunya ka janwari hala sagasi bazati.
When Amuna Sarfius was imprisoned,
Amuna Sarfius would only direct Tazi, the only Jesus that I could have with this.
And the Ethiopian metropolitan came to meet me in Cairo with three of the committee of Dayton, the managing of the church.
And to Papa's Ethiopian Christian, the source of which there the committee, the committee, went to Cairo, very much yes.
They asked me to go to Ethiopia for coordination in New Patria.
And now, when Ethiopia did Kabazuni, is that it hit the Lila Papas Lila Patria Kashmir?
I said to them, how can we ordain a patriarch while New Patriarch Abuna Sophilus is still alive?
Many negative Yaki La is a Mushu, indeed, Lila Patriarchu Bishop, and now Ye Allah Patriarchu Gana Jayota.
They said many bad words about the bonus of yours.
Guzu is one girl, La bonus of yours, Gana.
And they said he is not worthy to be patriarch. I said to them, if you have any accusation against him, the Holy Synod of Ethiopia should try, and the Holy Synod should have a decision, not anybody else.
Many people said, I want to confuse my salary.
We wanted to maintain and support the authority of the Ethiopian Church and the authority of its Holy Synod.
Ye Ethiopia many Christian Sulta. And now ye Ethiopia Christian Holy Synod Sultan, Kenya Makabar Madrid.
I refuse to go to Ethiopia for coordination in Utah Prayer.
Thank you.
And I call the Holy Synod of the Gothic Church for a meeting.
And now the Gothic Alexander Christian Synod, La Anisabsara Tarmaki.
And we said, all of us, we had a decision.
And now election, the Anisabs.
That we cannot recognize any patriarch from Ethiopia during the lifetime of patriarch Sophius.
Lera patriarch, the Ethiopian Christian, La Makabal, please, La Makabal, and Shilim, La Abuna Sophius, I was already seen.
Since that time, we have not any formal or official relation.
Kazakhse Udari is a process, official Malibu government, we Makabar Yeri.
But at the same time, We had deep relations and deep love with the Ethiopian people. Anyone who left Ethiopia and came to Egypt was deeply welcomed in our Papal
residence.
We welcome also many of the Ethiopian monks in our residence and in our
seminary.
And when Abuna Takla, the monk of Ethiopia, departed from this world, also some of the Ethiopians came to me as if the problem is already finished by the death of that man.
And now, Nigeria, we need to not hear my social group, but I want to say, most of my group, we need to talk about
it. I said to them, we want to know only one question: is Abuna Thawfius alive or not?
And the Yaki, in your personal garden, Abuna Thawfius.
If Abuna Thawfius is still alive, the problem is still existing.
Abuna Thawfius, by the way, the honor, children, Ghana is going better.
We want to help you.
Yeah, Ghana, Masai,
we want to support you. You are people who love the church. And who want to maintain the rules of the church and the canons of the church. And you want to maintain the tradition of the church.
And now,
I think more than 10 years ago, I was visited by one of the metropolitans of Sioux.
And to Ethiopia, the Papa's mentally,
he was a pious man, a holy man, very mean and sound.
This is Adam produce Papa's nation.
I welcomed him in my residence.
Now, when he reads,
he asked me to give him one of my crosses and one
skin.
And he asked me to let me put this leather cross on him.
And
I and he asked me to pray for them. I asked him, what is your diocese, please?
አባታችን አሁን ጀምረን ታየን የት ቦታ የት አውራጃ ሀገር ስብከት የት ሀገር ስብከት የሚርሶ ስብከት
ይሄ And then this old and holy man wept.
Yeah, when he's magili passo lunch.
I was deeply touched. Holy word.
Na isu እንደዚህ አዘና ዘበለ ተሰማ
I asked the name tell me please what is your name
ini tadi lemon message baru english lemonnya
he said to me now my last mother's
ya guys katil ila
I was obliged to write my resignation.
The grid, yini kuda kuota mautat, bato grid, set.
And a new bishop was ordained in my place.
And na adisu papas, bengi bota, tafu.
And he said to me, 8 metropolitans are the same, of the same group.
Na, በመጀመሪያ ስምንት ተፈጽሞች እንደዚህ ከአገረ ስብከት ወጡና ሌሎች ወጡ።
And then I heard that the number became 14.
ከዛ በኋላ ከአገረ ስብከት ይሄ ተፈጽሞ በተቆጣ ወጡ 14 ሆኑ።
According to the tradition of our church.
በእኔ ቤተ ክርስቲያን ትምህርት
There is no
resignation.
There is no resignation for any bishop or any metropolitan.
Papas will leave the papas with a lot of the Toronto Island.
He is priest forever as Marquisal.
Cassis with a Toronto Island. So Cassis in the Marquisal is called. This country is called Darabis.
If there is a father, we cannot say to any father, you can resign and we have another father with this. Give it in the country.
And our father will be to the Jackson. And our father will be
The father of the church remains the father even after his
death.
For this reason, we speak about Saint Athanasius as our father after his death. We speak about San Cyril as our father after his death. We speak about all the fathers of the church as fathers.
በዚህ ምክንያት እስካሁን ድረስ እኛ አሁን አቡነ አሰናሲዮስ እንነገራለን እሱ የኛ አባት እስካሁን ድረስ ደግሞ ሲኪሪሎስ ወይም ሲሪል እስካሁን ድረስ አባታችን እና ሌላ በቤተ ክርስቲያን ብዙ አባቶቻችን አለና እስካሁን ድረስ በሞቱ ጊዜ ብዙ ጊዜ በፊት ግን እስካሁን ድረስ አባቶቻችን እንላለን።
We want to help you and support you.
ትልቅ እርዳታ ለእናንተ መስጠት እንፈልጋለን።
But now I can say to you Our church is your church. Our priests are your priests. And your priests are our own priests. When Abuna Paulus visited me in New York, he participated with us in the Holy Liturgy, and we prayed together as one church.
Abuna Paulus in New York, we see too. Many a hand lay, Kedasi, Kadasanadna, Kudus Kurban, was the.
And all the Ethiopians who came with him could partake in the Holy Communion with us.
In Ethiopia, is the Christianoch za Maguban Baba to see the Kudus Kurban in Yakaratamo was the couple.
Put in your mind forever. That the Protestant Church and the Ethiopian Church are only one church for us. And I give you this cross to be put in your church.
And I hear Maskal.
And I have some crosses to give every one of you one position.
And I have some crosses to give every one of you one position.